Friends, the workmen unions consisting of AABA, NCB, NOBW and INBF has on 20th November sent two letters to Mrs. Nirmala Sitharaman, Honorable Minister for Finance, Government of India. These joint letters are sent seeking the Minister's intervention in the three important matters related to serving and retired bank employees. These letters are sent as a follow-up action on the following three crucial issues. The issues are management contribution to NPS at 14%, improvement in family pension and increase in ex gratia for pre-1986 retirees. In the first letter, the unions bring to the attention of the minister the fact that they had demanded switching over to old pension scheme for employees who had joined the banks from 1st April 2020. As they are covered by the new pension scheme. IBA had informed that NPS was introduced in banks and other sectors based on government policy and hence they could not accept the demand of the unions. Therefore, the unions had demanded that alternatively the contribution of the management in respect of such employees who had joined the banks on or after 1st April 2020 may be revised and increased to 14% as was done in the case of government employees. After discussions, IBA had agreed to the same but subject to approval from Government of India. Accordingly, the same has been incorporated in the settlement signed between the unions and IBA on 11th November 2020. As per the provisions of the settlement, the revised pay scale and allowances etc. are effective from November 2017 and is going to be implemented in all the banks shortly. But the provisions of the revised rate on contribution on NPS can be implemented only after receipt of government approval. So the unions in their joint letter is requesting the finance minister to expedite the approval from government so that the revised provisions can be implemented by all the banks. The second letter sent by the unions is related to revision in ex gratia amount payable to pre-1986 retirees and spouses. In this letter, the unions are inviting the Honorable Minister's attention to the history of the pension system in banks in India. The pension scheme for bank employees was introduced in banks other than State Bank of India with effect from 1st January 1986. The pension benefit as per the scheme approved by the government covered employees who retired from the banks from January 1986 onwards. Therefore, those employees who had retired prior to 1986 were not covered by the pension scheme. But on representation from such employees or retirees, government issued their guidelines in 1998 by which such pre-1986 retirees were extended an ex gratia of Rs. 300 per month plus DA thereon. Then in 2006, the government issued another set of guidelines extending an ex gratia of Rs. 1000 without DA for the surviving spouses or widows of such pre-1986 retirees. Again, in 2013, the government revised the guidelines and advised that the pre-1986 retirees may be paid Rs. 350 plus DA per month and their surviving spouse may be paid Rs. 300 plus DA. As on date, in the 11 public sector banks in India, which are covered by the guidelines of the government, there are only about 2,500 pre-1986 retirees and about 2,800 surviving spouses or widows of the pre-1986 retirees. Their age today is more than 94 years old. Since they retired at the age of 60 in 1986, that is 34 years ago. The total cost of ex gratia paid to them per month is only around Rs. 1.50 crores or 20 crores per year, covering all the 11 public sector banks put together. The unions are informing the finance minister that they have been requesting IBA and the government to consider enhancement and revision in their ex gratia. The matter is pending consideration of the government for a very long time. Therefore, the unions are seeking the finance minister's intervention in the matter and instructions to suitably revise and enhance the ex gratia amount. These two letters addressed to the FM indicates that the workmen unions are following up with IBA and government for the implementation of the remaining demands of the serving and retired bank employees. Let's hope that their request to the FM will be considered favorably and the bank employees will be able to get positive results in the important demands made by them.